Okay, good morning to one and all. Today we are discussing about single source shortest path by using general weights. Okay, suppose any graph, that is the any directed graph, that is the any directed graph having negative length edges. Suppose here -1, -2, -2, -1. Suppose if any graph has negative length edges, suppose G is a graph having negative length, that is the negative length, that is the negative length edge, it not give correct answer by using greedy method. So it not give correct answer by using greedy method to find the shortest path from single source to all destinations. From a single source to all from first vertex to remaining vertex, that is in our explanation, first we are finding the shortest path from single source, that is the first vertex to all the devices, that is the second vertex, third vertex, fourth vertex, and next one is fifth vertex, single sixth vertex, seventh vertex. So you are finding shortest path by using negative edges, that is some and all edges in directed graph G may have negative length of edges. In greedy method, you are not allowing negative length of edges. That is, already we are studying single source shortest path in greedy method. But in greedy method, you are not allowing negative length of edges. That is, the negative length of edges. So you are using negative length of edges. It not give correct answer. So in dynamic programming, negative length of edges are permitted. This negative length of edges are permitted. You require that the graph has no cycles of negative length. That is, the graph have no cycles of negative length. So you are finding shortest path. That is, the shortest path, finite number of edges. That is, here you missing. So you are finding the shortest path consists of finite number of edges. That is, the finite number of edges means, suppose you are finding the shortest path with the minimum number of edges, that is, so single edge, two edges, three edges, four edges, five edges. Suppose you are finding the shortest path by using only single edge, that is 1 to 2 or 1 to 3 or 1 to 4, you are using only single edge. Next, we are finding the shortest path two edges, that is, we are finding the shortest path by using two edges. Next, we are finding the shortest path from single source to all destinations by using three edges. At most three edges. Some paths you are not available three edges, only available two edges or three edges. We are finding at most three edges. Next. So dynamic program, you are finding the shortest path consists of finite number of edges. So when you are using, that is when there are no cycles on the negative length, there is a shortest path between any two vertices, that is, there is a shortest path between any two vertices, of n vertex graph, you having at most n minus one edges on it. That is, at most n minus one. That means, suppose the graph has, that is, the graph has seven vertices. That is, the graph has seven vertices. The shortest path have at most n minus vertices. That is, the at most n minus one means six edges. Suppose at most n minus edges means the any shortest path having at most n minus one edges means, that is, you are finding any shortest path from 1 to 7. So at most seven edges, because the total number of vertices is 7. So you are finding any shortest path. The shortest path has at most n minus one edges. So the shortest path have more than n minus one. Suppose if any shortest path have more than n minus one, must repeat at least one vertex. So suppose if any shortest path has more than n minus one edges, the vertex must be repeated. That is, the vertex must be repeated and it must be contain cycles. So you must eliminate the cycle. That is, you must eliminate the cycles. That is, you must eliminate the cycle. You must eliminate the cycles. That is, you must eliminate the cycles from the path resulting from another source vertex to destinations. Next, the path is cycle free. That is, suppose the path is cycle free and has length has length has is no more than the original path, and eliminate the cycles that at least zero, and you observe that the minimum number of edges, that is the minimum number of edges on the cycle free shortest path to be obtained algorithm to determine the shortest path from single source to all the remaining vertices. So our main problem is we are finding the shortest path, that is we are finding the shortest path from single source to all destinations. Suppose, for example, it is we are finding the shortest path from 1 to 2. So we are finding the shortest path from 1 to 2 by using single edges. That is, by using only single edges means the shortest path is directly from 1 to 2, that is 6. Suppose we are finding the shortest path from 1 to 2 by using two edges. That is, by using two edges, that is, there is another path from 1 to 2. That is, there is another path from 1 to 2. That is, the number of edges, that is, the number of edges in the shortest path is 2. That is 1, 2, 3. And next one is 3, 2, 2. That is 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 3. Shortest path is 5, 5 minus 2, 3. Suppose here 3. That is, suppose you are finding the shortest path by using number of edges. That is, the number of edges means, suppose we are using here only single edge, that is, we are finding shortest path by using single edge, that is, the length of the shortest path is 6 from 1 to 2. But for same vertex, that is, for the same x, we are finding the shortest path from 1 to 2 by using two edges, that is, by using two edges, the shortest path is 2. Next, we are finding the shortest path from 1 to 2 by using three edges. Suppose there is no path exist by using three edges. We are finding at most three edges. Suppose it is not available the path, just we are finding the number of edges, that is, the number of edges is only 2. So our main problem, is we are finding the single source shortest path, that is, we are finding the shortest path from single source to all the destinations, first of all. Second, from single source to all the destinations by using single edge. First one, by using single edge, or by using two edges, or by using three edges, or by using four edges, or five edges, or six edges, the at most n minus one edges. Suppose the graph has n vertices, you are finding n minus, that is, the shortest path having at most n minus one edges. So first we are finding the shortest path from single source, that is, from single source to all destinations, it means at most n minus one edges. So next, so to find the shortest path, that is, let distance power L of U, that is, L means the number of edges in the shortest path, U means destination vertex, that is, the destination vertex means the length of the shortest path from source vertex to all the destinations, that is, U means destinations. Here L represents the number of edges in the shortest path, the number of edges in the shortest path, that is, distance power L. L represents the number of edges in the shortest path, that is, the number of edges in the shortest path is 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or up to n minus 1. Suppose if any graph has n vertices, that is, the shortest path has at most n minus 1 edges. So let distance LU be the length of the shortest path from source vertex V to the vertex U under the constraint that the shortest path is shortest path contains at most L minus one edges. Suppose at most means it contains one edge, two edge, or three edge, or four edge. It contains at most L edges. So distance power 1 U represents the cost of U comma U, that is 1 less than or equal to U less than or equal to N. That is 1 less than, not less than or equal to U less than or equal to N. Clear, when there is no cycle in the negative path, that is, there is no cycle in the shortest path, you can limit our search for shortest path with at most N minus 1 edges. That is, suppose there are three edges is not available, we are using only two edges, at most three edges. So hence the distance n minus n is used, the length of the shortest path with from u to u, that is the length of the shortest path from v to. So for to find the shortest path, you are consider the, you are consider the constraints, that is we are consider the constraints. So our goal is the compute distance n minus 1 u. So we are calculating distance n minus 1, distance power n minus 1 u. Suppose to calculate distance n minus 1 u, first we are calculate distance n minus 1 2. So to calculate distance power n minus 1 2, next we are first we are calculating distance power n minus 2. That means distance power, first we are calculating distance power 1, distance power 1 u. So by using distance power 1 u, you are calculating distance power 2. Next, you are calculating by using distance power 2, you are calculating distance power 3. Next, we are calculating distance power 4 by using distance power 4. So up to distance power n minus 1 means distance power n minus 1 is calculated by using distance power n minus 2. So our goal is compute distance power n minus 1 u for all u. This can be done by using dynamic programming. First, you make the following observations that if the shortest path from u to v with the utmost k edges, that is the utmost k edges, for example, utmost k edges, k greater than 1, the edges has no more than k minus 1 edges. That is the edges has no more than k minus 1 edges. So distance power k equal to u equal to distance power k minus 1 u. So next, if the shortest path from u to v is u, v represents single source, that is 1 in our problem 1. U represents the remaining vertices, that is u represents the remaining vertices with the utmost k, k greater than 1, the edges has exactly k edges, then it made up shortest path from v to some vertices j followed by from vertices j followed by the edge j comma u. The path from u to j has k minus 1 edges, its length from then its length distance power k minus 1 j. Next, all the edges from I to, that is all the edges from I to such edges I to u, that is I to u in the graph are candidates for j, then you instruct the shortest path initialize I with the minimized distance power k minus 1 I plus cost of I comma u's correct value. So by using the observation, you are finding the formula. It is, we are writing the formula. This is called elimination formula. It is the elimination formula. It is distance power k u. Distance power k represents the number of edges. U represents the destination vertex. That is the destination vertex. This destination, that is u means 2r, 3r, 4r, 5. This distance u means distance power k. Distance power k represents the number of edges. U represents the destination vertex. That is the destination vertex means, the destination vertex means you are finding the shortest path from first vertex, means u means either 2r, 3r, 4r, 5. So u represents, that is the u represents 2r, 2 u represents 2r, 3r, 4r, 5r, 6r, 7. So distance k u equal to the minimum of distance k minus 1 u and minimum of I distance power k minus 1 I plus cost of I comma j. So by using recurrence, you are compute distance power k. Distance power k from k minus 1. That means first we are calculating distance power 2, next to distance power 3, next to distance power 4, and next to distance power 5. Next we are calculating distance power 5. So initially, that is for initial vertex, that is for initial vertex. So suppose there is any graph, that is any graph with negative edges, that is negative edges, we are finding the shortest path from single source to all the destinations. Here v and remaining vertices, that is the remaining vertices is u, that is u is either 2r, 3r, 4r, 5r, 6. So we are finding the shortest path from single source to all the destinations by number of edges. That is here main our problem is number of edges. So we are finding the shortest path from 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4, 1 to 5, 1 to 6, 1 to 7 by using single edge. This is one problem. It is that means it represents distance power 1 i. It is distance power 1 i means you are finding the shortest path from from single source to I represent destination vertex. Suppose you are consider one is source vertex, I represent 2, 3, 4, 5. That is I represent 2, 3, 4, 5. So we are finding the shortest path. That is we are finding the shortest path from single source to all the destinations by using number of edges. Number of edges means suppose first we are considering distance power 1 means the number of edges in the shortest path is 1. So it represents 1 to 1, that is distance 1, that is distance 1 from 1 to 2. That is so first 1 to 1 0, that is 1 to 1 0 means 1 to 1 0. Distance power 1 means the initial cost matrix, that is the initial cost matrix. It is distance power 1. Distance power 1 means shortest path is 1. Suppose distance power 1 means 0. Distance power 2 means is 1 to 2. That is 1 to 2, 6. Is 1 to 2, 6. Next one, 1 to 3. It is 1 to 3, 5. It is 1 to 3, 5. Next one, that is 1 to 3, 5 means distance power 1, 3 equal to 5. Next. Distance power 1, 4 is the length of the shortest path from first vertex to fourth vertex means single edge is 5. Next, distance 5. So there is no path, direct connection between 1 to 5. Suppose there is a connection between 1 to 5, but by using two edges, but first one represent, that is one represents by we are finding the shortest path by using single edge. We are finding the shortest path by using single edge. So there is no connection between 1 to 5 directly by using single edge. So length is infinity. Same, there is no connection between 1 to 6. That is, there is a connection between 1 to 6, but there is no connection between 1 to 6 by using single edge. Distance power 1 represents, we are finding the shortest path by using single edge. We are finding the shortest path by using single edge. There is no direct connection between 1 to 6. So shortest path is, there is no connection between 1 to 6 directly by using single edge. So 1 to 6 is infinity. So there is no direct connection between 1 to 7. So the shortest path is, there is no connection between 1 to 7 by using single edge. So 1 to 7 is infinity. As is distance power 2 equal to 6. Distance power 1, 3 equal to 5. Distance power 1, 4 equal to 5. Distance power 1, 5 equal to infinity. Distance power 1, 6 equal to infinity. Distance power 1, 6 equal to infinity. That means we are finding the shortest path by using single edge. So next we are finding the shortest path by using two edges, that is distance square. Here distance power u equal to minimum of distance k minus 1. So u represent destination vertices, that is destination vertices. So u represent destination means u represent 2r, 3r, 4r, 5r, 6r, 7. So distance square means we are finding the shortest path. From first vertex to second vertex by using two vertices. We are finding the shortest path from first vertex to second vertex by using two edges. So by using the same formula, suppose u equal to 2, k equal to 2. K equal to 2 means, that is k equal to 2 means the number of edges is 2. Finding the shortest path from first vertex to second vertex by using two edges. So minimum of distance k minus 1. K minus 1 means 2 minus 1, 1. U represents 2. Next, minimum of I. I represents 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Next, distance power k 1 I distance power I distance power I plus cost of I comma minus 1. So you are finding the shortest path. That is, we are finding the shortest path from first vertex to second vertex. That is, here 2 represent second vertex with minimum number of edges is 2. So you are calculating here distance square 2 equal to 2 is 3. How we are getting 3 means we are finding the shortest path from first vertex to second vertex by using second vertex means by using 2 edges. So suppose in our graph, so we are finding the shortest path from first vertex to second vertex by using 2 edges. So there is another path with two edges. That is, suppose the number of edges, that is the number of edges is 2 means one vertex, two vertex. So we are finding the shortest path from first vertex to second vertex by using 2 vertex means 5 minus 2, 3. That is, we are getting 3. How we are getting 3 means how we are getting 3 means we are finding the shortest path from first vertex to second vertex, that is first vertex to second vertex by using 2 edges. By using 2 edges means 5 1 2 3 3 2 2. So we are finding 1 2 2 3 is the shortest path. We are calculating same by using this formula. So distance power 1, we are calculating same. We are including here same distance 2, minimum of 6. That is, the 6 represents distance power 2. That is, distance power u. Distance power u means distance power 2. Distance power 2 equal to 6. Distance power 2 equal to 6. That is, 6 means 6 already we are representing here 6. That is 6, 6, 5, 5, infinity, infinity. Same we are writing 0, 6, 5, 5, 5, 5, infinity. Cost matrix, same infinity. So distance power 2 equal to a minimum of, that is, the minimum of distance I 1, 1 plus cost of 1 comma u. 1 comma u means 1 comma 2. So for cost of distance 1 comma distance 1 plus 1 plus cost of 1 comma 2. Next 2 comma 2, 2 comma 2, that is cost of 2 comma 2. Distance 3 comma 3 comma 2. Next distance 4 comma 2. So the values, that is, the values is 0 plus 6 and 6 plus 0 and 5 minus 2. 5 plus infinity, infinity plus infinity, infinity plus infinity, infinity plus infinity. That is, the minimum value is 6, 6, 3, 5 minus 2, 3, 5 plus 2, 5 plus infinity, 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 6 comma 3, 3. How we are getting 3? How we are getting 3 means we are finding the shortest path from first vertex to second vertex with 2 edges. 5 minus 2, that is 5 minus 2. How we are getting 5 minus 2? 5 minus 2, that is first 5, next one 2, that is 5 minus 2 ticks. That is, we are finding the shortest path, distance power 2, 2. Distance power 2, 2 means, distance power 2, 2 means, we are finding the shortest path by using 2 edges. We are finding the shortest path by using 2 edges. That is, distance power 2, 2 means, we are finding the shortest path from first vertex to second vertex by using 2 edges. Same, we are calculating distance power 2 equal to 3. Distance power 2 equal to 3. Distance power 2 equal to 4. Distance power 4 equal to 5. Distance power 2 5 equal to 5. Distance power 6 equal to distance power 2 equal to 6 means 4. How we are getting 4? 4 means we are finding the shortest path from first vertex to, that is, from first vertex to sixth vertex by using two edges. Same, for example, that is, for example, here we are clear. Suppose we are finding the shortest path from first vertex to sixth vertex by using two edges. So that is 5 minus 1, 4. Same, you are getting 5 minus 4. Same. Yes, 4, 5 minus 1, 4. Same, you are getting 5 minus 4 here. Distance 4, that is distance square I 4. How we are getting 4 means 5 minus 4. Suppose 5 means you are finding the shortest path from first vertex to fifth vertex by using 2 edges. How we are getting 5? So you are calculating same procedure, you are following same procedure, but in shortcut you are finding the shortest path. That is, you are finding the shortest path by using 2 edges. So you are finding the shortest path from 2 edges means, suppose we are finding the shortest path from single source, that is from single source to shortest path means, that means suppose there is a two paths, that is there is a two path exist from fifth vertex, that is 1 to 2, and next one is 2 to 5. There is a one path, that is 6 minus 1, 5. So there is another path, that is the another path by using 2 edges, that is 5, 5 plus 1, 6, but shortest path is 5. So 6 minus 1, 5, same, you are getting 6 minus 1, 5, 5. That is, suppose you are finding the shortest path by using 2 edges, we are getting same distance square 5 equal to 5. So same procedure, that is we are following same procedure. We are finding distance square 2, distance square 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Same distance power 3 equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is totally we are calculating distance power 4, 5, 6, 7. Finally, we are calculating distance power 6. So in next class, we are calculating all the vertices. That is distance square 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Distance cube power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next distance cube 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So